Hey everyone, and welcome to PlayStation Home, a place where we will constantly see people chatting like this while wearing, well, basically being half naked, and actually all being male even though they're females. Or at least they look like females. What we have over here is basically Sully's Bar. In this section, we can actually go ahead and show you that they have a nice outdoor patio, which is full of little seats for people that they could actually be sitting in, away from other people if they wanted to talk about their 12-year-old problems. Nobody does that. No, instead they sit here and stand in the middle of things like this, and then, you know, you just get spammed the fuck out, can't really tell what you're doing. Oh, Lord. People seem to like this area, though. I've recorded this a few times. It's really easy to become distracted by the people talking, and at a certain point, I just start making fun of them, and it's not very useful. So I just kind of want to keep it actually about Uncharted in this fourth take, for fuck's sake. Here we have what it looks like a small, mini documentary type thing about the U-boats. I don't know, there's no sound, it's just some video, and you can zoom in on it, and you're actually in the engine when you do so, so it's kind of weird. I don't know, we're gonna leave that. Oh Lord. 12-year-old problems are getting pretty serious over here. So as you can see, they actually fully render the bar outside. There's like a little swamp area. I don't really know where this bar could possibly be, but whatever. There's lots of little seats. Again, nobody really uses these things unless they're being creepy and voyeuristic and really just want to stare at other people's conversations all day. Which, really, I don't want to do. Over here, we have the Smuggler's Den area. This is another area where people could actually be talking, but aren't. It's a social area. There's really not much to these areas aside from a couple artifact viewers, a few other minor things like that. For example, we'll go ahead and pull up an artifact viewer real quick here. Here's the artifact viewer. As you can see, it sort of just lets you toss around through the room, finding the individual artifacts. Oh, they're not the same, though. They seem to have lost a lot of resolution and decoratives. I mean, this had red jewels on it, so that had jewels on it, and looks really low res here. But yeah, basically this area is sort of just a quick spot. You can sort of... It's basically an advertising space for the Uncharted series. There's lots of art over here from the, what I would guess are cinematic paintings. Typically, they tend to use these things to determine the lighting before they actually go into fully producing cinematics. Really cool stuff here. I really like this painting of Drake. It's awesome. Over here, we have a lot of fish animals. It really fits the bar setting, but I really don't know why it's here because... I mean, you never kill any fish or animals or anything, but whatever, it's a bar. Anyway, we're going to head back into the main area and through the 12-year-old conversation again. It always loads every time you do this, and it always starts you at the beginning, so again, we have to sort of go back through this mess. And what you can see here are some people playing the arcade games, which is Mercenary Madness. This is a game that they probably created specifically for advertising purposes. Here you'll notice if you try to play an arcade game while someone's playing it, it'll be occupied. Most of the time, you're going to see all the arcade games occupied. And in Home, there's this weird thing where you end up sort of... stupid chat. You sort of end up just waiting on people. Like, in reality, and everyone knows that everybody wants to play video games where you have to stand in line. That's super fun. Especially when you find out you're standing in line for a game like this, which is just sort of a Pitfall clone. It's sort of interesting, I guess. I mean, it's really here just as a time waster, and it honestly couldn't have taken too long to program it. So, I mean, I'm sure it's getting its worth... maybe. I'm not really... I have no idea what the qualifications of what it makes something worth it when you're trying to advertise on a home space. I would assume that it would be more like the avatars on Xbox Live, where you'd want to focus on creating outfits and stuff people would buy for like 99 cents. Because if you've noticed out there, we'll go back out and sort of look at it, but... Oh, fuck! But we'll go back out there and look at it. But the 12-year-old populace that's arguing out there is fully decked out in, like, purchased clothes from PlayStation Home. Probably have spent, you know, who knows, $30, $40, $50 of their parents' money. Or if not, they're, you know, creepy 50-year-old people pretending to be that very thing, which is, you know, no better. But at least it's their own income. Yeah, so... Well, basically, what I'm saying is I'm not really sure why they would spend the time to develop this unless they had some side company that actually does that to make these little mini games. But there are quite a few of them in the home space. Oh, fuck, really? I can't believe I just bugged the home game. Oh my god, what the fuck has happened? I'm quitting you. I don't even want to deal with this. Oh, Lord. All right, so let's go take a look at some people, because fuck it. I feel voyeuristic now. Hey, guys, your conversation's on the internet. Congrats. So, as you can see, we have some people who've spent a good deal of money. They got a lot of custom outfits. I've seen this strange as weird person in at least maybe 20 different outfits. In fact, they're changing their outfit right now. So, what's new, girly girl? Just hanging out here, being a troll. Yep. Yes, you are. But yeah, I've seen them change through probably like 10 or 20 outfits trying to do this commentary. They've probably spent a damn good amount of money. And you know, when everyone says, well, who the fuck is playing home? These are the people. These are the people that are playing home right here. And this ninja guy who's also playing home. And this guy who's been dancing for like 12 hours. Anyway, over here we have some pictures of the cast. There are two more rooms which we need to explore. First one is the archives room, which is actually pretty interesting because it's not a complete waste of time. The other one sort of is. It's an artifact room. It's very similar. If you've beaten Uncharted, you can just look at the artifacts. So it's not really... I mean, it doesn't make a lot of sense. Here we have what looks like some storyboard concepts for the bunker level, I'm guessing. Over here, I've never seen this thing work. There's some seats. I guess it's supposed to be like the movie theater in Home, but I've never fucking seen this thing do anything. I don't know what it's here for. It's a complete waste of time. Maybe it was an ad for Uncharted 2. If that's true, why isn't it an ad for Uncharted 3? That's supposed to come out soon. I don't know. Here's concepts of them pulling El Dorado out, I think. As you can see, this is... I have no idea who that is. Here's some Drake concepts. I really hope this actually is Drake. Oh, you know, that's Navarro. Huh, I'm stupid. Over here, some mercenary concepts. It's a cool little room. I dig this room. There's a couple more artifacts. Not really going to pay attention to them. As you can see, the artifacts look pretty damn good from the default home view. But it's when you pop into... You pop into artifact view that starts looking kind of crappy. You know, let's look at the artifacts anyways. Why not? See here, this is clearly not rendering properly. Which is kind of sad, because they're in control of this. Here's Ikari's bong. And that's a pipe, I swear. If that can be a bong, that can be a pipe, period. Whoa. Huh. I love how it's actually... moving the camera to that location in the room, so every time you flip through, you're like, music? No music. Music? No music. Ah! Alright, well, we're done with this room. Let's go ahead and head over to the final room, which is the artifact room. We'll have to pass through the creepy 12-year-old conversations about important things. One more time. Sweet. At least they're not role-playing, like, they're not doing sex role-play anymore, which is good. One of the recordings I had to cancel was just absolutely... It was hilarious, but I couldn't stop laughing. I'll see if I could find that. It was actually, like, strips off your radiation suit, and there's no point in sexual RP. If you're typing the words, I strip off your radiation suit, just quit, man. Just quit while you're ahead. Thank you.
She gave you everything she had, but she was young and dumb. She just turned 21. She didn't care to hang around. So when the shit came down, while she was nowhere to be found, this life can turn a good girl bad. She was the sweetest thing that you had ever seen. You're such a delicate boy in the hysterical realm of an emotional. You could make grown men gasp when you'd go walking past them in your hot pants and high heels. They could not believe that such a body was for real. It seemed like rainbows would appear. Whenever you came near, the clouds would disappear because you looked just like a girl. Your baby blues would flash and suddenly a spell was cast. You're such a
Uncharted area. Anyway, this is the artifact room. As I was saying, the whole bunch of them are located in here. There's some nice arts. I mean, you got sort of his desk. I guess this is Sully's desk. I'm kind of sad because there used to be previously in a previous walkthrough here, I had two mafia guys. One was named like. Actually, they were dressed like mafia guys. One was named, like, Mountain Dew something, and the other one was Corleone, Don Corleone or something. Yeah, it was just weird, because I couldn't stop thinking about, like, what kind of conspiracy the mafia and Mountain Dew people are hooking up and creating in the Uncharted fucking room at this rate. Yeah, we can leave my conspiracy theories alone. Well, that's pretty much it for the Uncharted area. It's kind of, you can kind of see what's happened to it. It's, I mean, when it started, it was a nice advertising piece. Now it's basically just a place where 12-year-olds hang out and talk about their problems and show off outfits. Let's see what the outfits they're wearing, because I know they've changed them. Let's see, Hringar is still the same. Oh, there's Mountain Dew Freak. And Corleone Boss. They're down here. Discussing their secret strategies. At least attend a few more meetings. See? See what I mean? They really are talking secret strategies. It's not like I'm even fucking around here. No, come on. Strange is weird. You're the one that needs to render. You're the one that changes your clothes every 5 seconds. What awful thing are we gonna have? Come on. Okay! Damn, that is like... Seriously, that is like the 12th completely different outfit I've seen. I have no idea how much money this person has spent, but it's got to be a lot. I wonder if I can bring up their profile. Maybe they've got, like, a lot of unlocks or something. Oh, that's not worth it. What am I doing? Anyway, let's go ahead and get the fuck out of here, because this place kind of sucks. Sorry, Sully. Your bar's full of retards. Alright guys, that's it. I'm gonna head out of here because this place is awful, and I will see you guys inside Uncharted pretty soon. Peace. Get out of my face, War Eagle. Nice.